Good afternoon. Today's topic is log periodic antenna. So this is very important topic. Log periodic antenna. This was developed in 1957. Why this is called a log periodic antenna? Basically, it is an array antenna which has structural geometry such that its impedance is periodic with the logarithm of the frequency. It is a nonlinear array in which spacing of the elements as well as their dimensions are unequal. However, the excitation is uniform. Okay, so due to the unequal spacing, this is known as the non-linear array. As we have discussed, the structural geometry such that its impedance is periodic with the logarithm of the frequency. But it is basically called frequency independent antenna. Means the parameters of this antenna are not depend on frequency. It can be used to receive a good number of TV channels without any deterioration of the received field strength. Now you can see in this figure impedance characteristic of log periodic antenna. So this is the impedance, and you can see this graph is between the impedance and logarithm of frequency. Okay, it has been cut. I have taken this image. Okay, so in x-axis there is log f. Okay, so you can see this is the input impedance, and you can see the input impedance is periodic with respect to the frequency of the with respect to the logarithm of the frequency. Now the silent features of log periodic antenna. As we have discussed, it is a frequency independent antenna. The input impedance variation of the antenna with the log of frequency is periodic, and hence the name is the log periodic antenna. It is an array of non-identical dipoles which are all excited equally. It is a non-uniform array where the spacing between the elements is unequal. Next is the impedance. Directional pattern and directivity are constant with frequency. The gain of a well-designed antenna lies between 7.5 and 12 dBi. It is a broadband antenna. It has unidirectional characteristics. They are used in very high frequency and ultra frequency bands. They are used for TV reception and can receive a number of channels. Now you can see the structure of a log periodic antenna. See, this is the log periodic antenna, and in log periodic antenna you may see last here, this is L1, and L1 is equal to the lambda by 2. Okay, now see L2, L3, L4, Ln minus 1, Ln means these length is in decreasing order. Okay, this is the field line, and you can see the direction of the maximum radiation. Direction of maximum radiation is this side. Okay. Actually, you can see, you know, firstly, द लैम्डा और वेव लेंथ इज सी वाई एफ, मीन्स दिस इज हैविंग द इनवर्सली रिलेशन. ओके, हियर यू कैन सी द लेंथ इज लैम्डा बाई टू एंड दिस लेंथ इज डिक्रीजिंग. हियर यू कैन सी द लेंथ इज डिक्रीजिंग. इफ लेंथ इज डिक्रीजिंग इट मीन्स द फ्रिक्वेंसी इज इंक्रीजिंग. हैंस दिस इज द डायरेक्शन लोब और मैक्सिमम रेडिएशंस. ओके ओके, नाउ डिजाइन इक्वेशंस. यू कैन सी द डिजाइन इक्वेशन. द लेंथ एंड स्पेसिंग रिलेशनशिप इज गवर्न बाय द फॉलोइंग डिजाइन इक्वेशन. देर इज द स्केल फैक्टर बेसिकली डिनोटेड बाय द टाउ. सो टाउ इक्वल टू डी एन बाय डी एन माइनस वन इक्वल टू एल एन बाय एल एन माइनस वन. हियर एन इज 1 2 3 4. स्पेसिंग फैक्टर इज डिनोटेड बाय सिग्मा एंड दिस इज एस एन बाय टू एल एन आर इक्वल टू एस एन बाय एस एन माइनस वन. हियर यू कैन सी वन एंगल. दिस इज डिनोटेड बाय दिस अल्फा. दिस अल्फा इज नॉन एज द वेज एंगल और इंक्लूडेड एंगल. एन अल्फा इज डिनोटेड बाय टू टेन इनवर्स ब्रैकेट वन माइनस टाउ बाय फोर सिग्मा. द वैल्यू ऑफ टाउ एंड सिग्मा कैन बी फाइंड बाय द इस बेल कर्व फॉर अ स्पेसिफाइड गेन ऑफ एंटीना. नाउ द स्केल फैक्टर टाउ लाइज बिटवीन 0 एंड 1 फॉर अ गिवेन वेज एंगल अल्फा. इफ अल्फा इज लार्ज टाउ इज स्मॉल. द पैरामीटर इन टर्म्स ऑफ गेन इज इम्प्रूव्ड इफ टाउ इज स्मॉल एंड अल्फा इज लार्ज. नाउ सी द एनालिसिस ऑफ द लॉग पीरियोडिक अरे. दिस एनालिसिस इज डिस्क्राइब्ड इन टर्म्स ऑफ थ्री रीजन्स, कैपेसिटिव, रेजिस्टिव एंड इंडक्टिव रीजन. वेरी सिंपल. कैपेसिटिव रीजन, इफ द एलिमेंट्स आर शॉर्टर देन लैम्डा बाई टू एंड दे आर देन दे आर कैपेसिटिव, हेंस द करेंट लीड्स द अप्लाइड वोल्टेज बाय 90 डिग्री. दीज एलिमेंट्स प्रोड्यूस स्मॉल बैकवर्ड रेडिएशंस. नाउ द रजिस्टिव एलिमेंट्स. रजिस्टिव एलिमेंट्स मीन्स इफ द डाइपोल्स आर लैम्डा बाई टू लेंथ देन दे आर रजिस्टिव. द करेंट्स आर लार्ज एंड दे आर इन फेज विद द वोल्टेज. दीज एलिमेंट्स प्रोड्यूस कंसिडरेबल फॉरवर्ड रेडिएशंस. नाउ द इंडक्टिव. इंडक्टिव मीन्स इफ द एलिमेंट्स आर ऑफ लेंथ ग्रेटर देन लैम्डा बाई टू द करेंट्स लैग द वोल्टेज बाय 90 डिग्री. द एलिमेंट्स रिजल्ट्स द इंसिडेंट वेव इन द बैकवर्ड डायरेक्शन. द एक्टिव रीजन बैंडविड्थ इज गिवेन बाय दिस इज द फॉर्मूला यू कैन लर्न. बी ए मीन्स एक्टिव बैंडविड्थ इज इक्वल टू 1.1 प्लस 7.7 ब्रैकेट 1 माइनस टाउ का होल स्क्वायर कॉट अल्फा बाय टू. वेन द डिजाइंड बैंडविड्थ इज अज्यूम टू बी ग्रेटर देन द डिजायर्ड बैंडविड्थ इट इज गिवेन बाय डिजायर्ड बैंडविड्थ इज बी डी एंड डिजायर्ड बैंडविड्थ इज द बीटा टाइम्स ऑफ द एक्टिव बैंडविड्थ. सो यू कैन सी एक्टिव बैंडविड्थ इज डिनोटेड बाय बी ए एंड बीटा टाइम्स इट इज मल्टीप्लाई बाय द बीटा और बी. ओके, नाउ यू कैन सी दिस बी इंटू 1.1 प्लस 7.7 वन माइनस टाउ होल स्क्वायर कॉट अल्फा बाय टू विच इज द एक्टिव रीजन बैंडविड्थ बी ए. ओके, हेयर बी इज द डिजायर्ड बैंडविड्थ. नाउ द टोटल लेंथ ऑफ द अरे. द टोटल गिवन बाय एल इक्वल टू लैम्डा मैक्स बाय फोर ब्रैकेट वन माइनस वन बाय बीटा डी मीन्स डिजायर्ड बैंडविड्थ कॉट अल्फा बाय टू. हेयर लैम्डा मैक्स इज द ट्वाइस ऑफ द एल मैक्स which is denoted by the V naught by Fm, F min. And V naught is the velocity of propagation of electromagnetic wave in space. Now,
The number of elements in the array is given by capital N equal to 1 plus log BD by log 1 by tau. The average characteristic impedance Z naught average is given by 120 bracket log bracket ln by dn minus 2.25. Here a term dn is the diameter of the nth dipole. Okay, now yesterday we have discussed the Yagi-Uda antenna. So now what is the difference between log periodic and Yagi-Uda antenna? Basically, in a Yagi-Uda antenna, only one element is driven or feed, that is active element, while the other elements like directors or reflectors are parasitic elements. While in this log periodic antenna, you may see all elements are connected with the feed. Second thing, in Yagi-Uda antenna, gain is higher. Bandwidth is narrow and numerous side lobes are there. While in log periodic, it is a broadband antenna as we have discussed with virtually no side lobes and hence very directional but relatively low gain. Now you may see one numerical and based on log periodic antenna. So design a log periodic antenna to obtain a gain of 9 dB. And to operate over a frequency range of 125 MHz to 500 MHz. So here we required the gain, that is 9 dB, the lowest frequency given, that is 125 MHz, and the highest frequency is 500 MHz. We know the relation. If the frequency is highest, then we can find the lowest wavelength, and if the frequency is lowest, then we can find the longest wavelength. So longest wavelength by using the lowest frequency. So 3 into 10 to the power 8, which is the speed of light, or you can say the propagation of electromagnetic wave in free space, by 125 into 10 to the power 6. So we have 2.4 meter. Now the shortest wavelength which can be found by highest frequency, so lambda short equal to 3 into 10 to the power 8 by 500 into 10 to the power 6, so that is 0.6 meter. Now to obtain a gain of 9 dB, the values of a scale and scale factor and the spacing factors can be taken using the Isbell's curve. So if we find the value of tau and sigma for a gain of 9 dB, the value of tau will be 0.861 and sigma will be 0.162. Now the phase angle you may calculate using alpha equal to 210 inverse 1 minus tau by 4 sigma, that is 24.2 degree. Now we have tau dn by dn minus 1 ln by l minus 1 equal to that means if we have to find the value of the ln minus 1, we can calculate using tau into L1. Similarly, we can find L3 equal to tau into L2, L4 equal to tau into L3, etc. Now, L1 equal to lambda long by 2, that is 2.4 by 2, equal to 1.2 meter. Similarly, L2 equal to tau L1. The value of tau is 0.861 and the value of L1 we have calculated, that is 1.2 meter. So the answer is 1.0332 meter. Similarly, we can find the L3 tau into L2, that is 0.861, the value of the tau, and 1.0332, the value of L2. So we have 0.8895. All right. Similarly, we can find the values of others. Now, the element spacing. Element spacing is given by this sigma, and sigma equal to Sn by 2ln. Okay. So So Sn equal to 2 into Ln, or S1 equal to 2, Sn equal to 2 sigma, S1 equal to 2 sigma L1, the value of sigma is 0.162. So 2 into 0.162 into 1.2, that is 0.3888 meter. Similarly, we can find the others. So this is the spacing element and this is the length. Thus, we can design the log period antenna. Thank you so much.